on, a very warm welcome to this special as we look ahead to this Sunday blockbuster on our menu. It is India versus Pakistan, one of the biggest games in the tournament. Two countries we know likely to come to a standstill today. I am here with Anil Kumble, who has kindly agreed to come to the studio to be part of our show. So thank you very much, Anil. The last time we were discussing, he was in the studio, was in the 2011 World Cup, and we had quite a wonderful time with India winning the World Cup at that moment. Rohan Gavaskar is here with us, so thank you, Rohan. Hemang as well joins us.
After what he just said.
So it's good to have Anil here, because the last time he was here... So the last time Anil was here, India won the World Cup. Are they going to do it this time around? I'm also joined by Ayaz Memon, and he will tell us if the weather will allow us to do so. There is also Gaurav Kalra, who joins us from Bombay. So before I get to everybody, Ayaz needs to tell us whether the rain gods have been kind to the two teams today. Ayaz, what do you have from there?
It's now overcast, but there has been no precipitation. There has been no rain. And it looks like we might have, if this kind of weather holds up, then we'll have a prompt start.
But Ayaz, you're looking dashing in that blazer, you know, English style. So that's good to see. The raincoat's off. That's nice. Let me then begin with Anil. This is an important game, weather permitting. Both teams here would want to win this. I mean, this is important for India. They've already just split the point with New Zealand. They want to win it. And of course, then there's Pakistan, who are desperate for a win.
Yeah, it is. It is important for both teams. Pakistan yeah. See themselves at the bottom of the table.
As Ayaz mentioned, this could be a rain truncated game. In that toss becomes really crucial for both teams. So whoever wins the toss here would want to field first. We've talked about this, but in a situation like this, they'll have to adapt to it, both teams, especially for India. And Virat Kohli spoke about this also in the press conference, that with the weather now, you know, playing hide and seek, they'll have to change their strategies accordingly.
I think so. I think toss becomes crucial.
You were part of one of those moments. You'd got the front seat. Was that the most angry you saw Venkatesh Prasad get?
Venky can be aggressive, but that is one of the moments where he certainly got very angry. For the simple reason, I mean, if you looked at the score, Rohan showed me that score.
Yeah.
115 in 14 overs, yeah. 15 overs.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a lot of runs. And they were chasing 287. Like I mentioned, three Karnataka bowlers had to defend that, so obviously it was pressure on all three of us.
The first World Cup took place in 1975, but for India as a country to open her arms to the sport, it was the magnificent and totally unexpected win in 1983. Since then, cricket only became bigger, and 2011 was witness to the craze as India won the trophy at home, surrounded by their loyal fans. Now, even as the millennials of the country explore different fashions, one thing has remained constant since 83, India's undying love for the game. Hello and a very warm welcome. It's that time again when once in 4 years, a billion Indians will cheer for their team to be the champions of the world. It's nice to have these gentlemen here, because over the next month and a half, till 14th of July, we'll be talking cricket and we'll be talking World Cup. So let's begin with the first question then for you
and
guys.
And hopefully we talk about India till the 14th of July. That's
absolutely
what I want. Yeah.
So as India, you know, gets set to start the campaign, first match, what are you guys most excited about? Let's start with Rohan.
Well, I think, you know, we going into this tournament as co-favorites. I think England are favorites, and we are right up there with England.
Gaurav, for you, what are you looking forward to most, at least as soon as India begins the campaign? What is it that you're excited about?
I'm looking forward, Neha, to India finally getting started. It seems like they are latecomers to this party. Every other team seems to have played a couple of matches. Some have identified problems.
Ayaz, what do you make of this eve as, you know, India gets set to start their campaign? What was the vibe there? You know, how are the players preparing? Give us all the details.
Well, you know, look, a lot of things have happened in the past 2 or 3 days, because it seemed like a somnolent tournament, one-sided matches, not much interest, and then suddenly, boom.
We already know South Africa are coming off 2 losses in the tournament. This is going to be now a perfect opportunity for India to register a win over an opposition that is under serious pressure. You know, one of the good things though, Rohan, in this tournament, that India have had the time and they've had, you know, the think tank has looked at how all the other matches are being played. They've looked at the conditions, what are the totals that are being scored, and that in a sense would prepare them going into this match?
Oh yes, it would, because like Aya said, you know, you've got to be prepared to chase about 300 plus. That's par for course, 300, 330.
India win the toss and they'd like to bat first, because we've already established in this tournament, especially in the second half, the numbers are completely skewed in the favor of the team batting first. In fact, at Old Trafford, the five matches that have been played all have been won by the team batting first. So India then decides to, if they win the toss, decide to bat first. But then comes that crucial question of Indian openers dealing with the likes of Matt Henry, Lockie Ferguson, Trent Bolt in those overcast conditions.
Yes, I mean, that's something that you'll have to take a chance with. You'll have to back your batting to manage those situations, and I think they've done that throughout this tournament.
Now let's get in Hemang into this conversation, because it'll be interesting to know whether he still believes with those overcast conditions, he agrees with you of going in with two wrist spinners. So Hemang, what are your thoughts on it? Because now, this is almost after 2 weeks that we're getting this kind of weather. So you do have to look back, though we know that the pitches are slowed down. And on top of that, this is a fresh, this is a new pitch. There will be that conversation.
True, absolutely. They will be tempted to play another seamer, keeping in mind the conditions that we have right now.
Who were glued to the television screens. This is a heartbreaking moment as India lost to New Zealand in their semi-final and are now out of the World Cup. But it became so close at one point when Jadeja and MS Dhoni were batting, and Jadeja really playing a wonderful innings. It wasn't to be. A lot of Indian fans disappointed after that performance. But nevertheless, that's the result and we've got to live with it. India are out of the World Cup. Brilliant, brilliant effort, Hemang, from Ravindra Jadeja. MS Dhoni also tried to take it right till the end, but that run out by Martin Guptill, and it was absolutely sensational the way, and we know how brilliant a fielder Martin Guptill is, but at the end, really heartbreaking.
Well, yes, a heartbreak for an entire nation, a nation of a billion people, but at the same time, New Zealand fought hard, and I'd like to take this time to congratulate them.